welcome to Lignano. The atmosphere here is terrific, but it's raining cats and dogs. A force nightingale is blowing in from the sea. It's going to be one heck of a program, and the British team is Sherman.
Lignano, Sabbiadoro, an ultra-modern holiday complex on the Adriatic coast between Venice and Trieste. It's a rather bold experiment in modern holiday development. High-rise flats, lovely villas, pine forests, yachting marinas on the Adriatic coast. 5 miles of beach. And they have horses. Many horses. They also have a lagoon, water on three sides, and four horses. It's a spit of land on a peninsula, Lignano. There are three Lignanos, Lignano Riviera, and horses. Plenty of horses. Prince Charles not in sight. Lignano Sabbiadoro, Lignano Pineta, and Lignano Riviera. Three modern villages linked together over the last 30 years to form this enormous modern holiday complex. And here we are in the sports stadium. And a pool specially built for the game. An enormous Olympic-sized pool, but it's only 3 feet deep. And in the background, a modern set. Art Nouveau, the weather is horrendous. Michaela was all dressed up and slipped up and smart, ready to introduce the program, but unfortunately, like everybody else here, he's had to don massive oilskins. The German team leaders there, cheerleaders, I should say, wet through. Billy Carlucci is the co-presenter of the program tonight, along with Michaela. And now, here come the team. First of all, the Belgians from Toulouse, a little town in the very north of Belgium, near Ostend. Playing for the Swiss, Regensdorf. They're also in the north of Switzerland, the summer and winter resort. And from the French, the team of beach. There in the northeast, near the German border. It's the British team coming in on the left. Sherbert. With about 50 drenched supporters cheering them home. On the right, from the Azores, the island of San Miguel, playing for Portugal. Šibenik for Yugoslavia. They're from Dalmatia. And the home team of Lignano Sabbiadoro. Beautiful area with the chimpanzee as a mascot. A beautiful area, much loved by Julius Caesar, and it's very, very fertile and cold. As you geographers know, the Friuli. In comes Gennaro and Guido. On to the first game in the race.
Sei turiste pronte, abbiamo organizzato un gioco molto divertente, lo vediamo subito, partecipano sei squadre, io direi di dare...
And it's all about getting sweets. The Italians are famous for sweets. There are three palm trees in the middle of the aqua. And they take a sweet, one from each tree. That's Stanley Bunnell. And underneath the animal is a gentleman called Ian Rowe. They've got to take a sweep from each tree. And we've never played the game in the rain, so everything is soaking wet. There's a little bit of grease on as well, so there'll be hijinks that really aren't scheduled. There's Sally. You've got to go to each tree, take a sweep from each tree, and then belt back to base. Well, Sally's a teacher way back in Sherbin, and she teaches little boys, so you can all have a great big giggle at Sally Bunnell, blonde tresses flowing in the wind and the rain, gathering sweets for Sherbin and Great Britain. chaos rules at the moment. There's a cow in the foreground, the pig, the Italians are on the way back with the black cat. The Italians have got the green feet, and the Belgians. Sally is up the palm tree for her third sweep, but that's the game, can you see? A lollipop, a candy floss, and a licorice. First, Italian. Second, the Belgians. Oh, the Portuguese have dropped off. The Portuguese are on the way back. The French are coming. Where is Ian Rowe? I think we're going to finish last if we're not careful. I think Sally's dropped a sweep. She keeps melting the head of her beast, which is a mouse. But there are the Portuguese on a cow. Well, we've had to wait and see what is happening. Well, that's no good, Ferrier. We needed three sweeps. The worm penny. The Gennaro told you, Britain's gone and Portugal's gone. 6 points for Lignano, that's what they wanted, the home crowd. Bit of it by the rain, there's the bearing status. Just 1 point for us. No jokers played. Millie is fighting her way through the rain, introducing the Italian team. One's been on spaghetti and one's been on a diet. In the Ville Rouge, seven teams play, two boys from each team. The job to go collecting cake. They go into this beautiful set. In the background, you can see loads and loads of cakes, about 100 cakes backstage. They have to collect three cakes, and the time is taken. The Ville Rouge is run in 40, and you have to better your time in each heat. Get a lightning time in the first heat. You'll have to go like the clappers to beat it. But the blue cakes, they go for the blue cakes. There are five colours backstage. Five colours, and everybody goes for blue. Hoping for a fast time. But if you don't put up a fast time, then in the three remaining heats, you may better it. Don't worry about it. Just sit back and enjoy it. We're in the red. Backstage, the cakes. They're going for blue. That's our boy, the team captain, Chris. We have one cake. The US Bars have one. The French have one. Best time for... Yes. A lot is happening in there. You can squeeze through as best you can. We've got two. Oh, well done. That's Chris again. But where's our fat man? Our fat guy is a little guy, actually, called Tim. Look at that. It's like the any school in Great Britain at 4 o'clock. Let's get out of that. The Italians coming for two. If we can find a way, that's our fat man pressing there. I'm sure it is. There's our slim down. Oh! He's swimming for the shore, and if he gets it on, it's three. And could be a good time. That's our boy, his costume soaking wet, but if he puts that cake on the table, we have three, yes? We've gone up. We have the third fastest time. The fastest, I think, was a Swiss. then the Italians, or the Yugoslavs, then the British. We make our time 1:34, which is very, very respectable. But don't forget, the three remaining heats of the Fil Rouge, as usual in international programs, take place. You know when they come. We've got to try and beat that time. And two different boys play the Fil Rouge in each heat. Oh, what a lovely shot. Tim Bartley, he makes guided missiles in secret, in a hideaway somewhere in Dorset. A very clever gentleman, that is. And I bet he never thought he'd appear in a fat costume playing for Sherman and Britain gathering cakes. Uno vede 127. 134 Schabenick. 131 for Regensdorf. 133 for Sherman. 1:35 for Belgium. 2 minutes maximum for Portugal and for France, and also 2 minutes limit time. You've got the game now, we've got to beat that. We have to beat 1:33 on the next round. 1:30 is excellent, 1:25 is with bang. Our joker's coming in, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and in the foreground.
Yes, tell me something about this costume. I am Sir Walter Raleigh of Sherborne Castle. Ah, ecco, lei ha un costume che è tipico di Sherborne, del castello di Sherborne, che è una località che ha un castello antico.
Nelle Carlucci didn't know who Walter Raleigh was.
Allora,
she just said it's a typical costume we always wear at Sherborne Castle.
Ecco, abbiamo un altro
joker. So that was Sarah Lee playing our joker.
Beh, sappiamo che Cesare, la sua celebre frase, già detratto e conquistò mezzo mondo, ma ci posso conquistare la finale a Belgrado.
E la scimmia è il vostro portafortuna. Okay, allora,
the Italian joker, he is dressed as Julius Caesar, because Julius used to come here every holiday. And the game. We go first. The poor girl on the run. He's decorating with stars. She's an apprentice star. She is Penny Fowler. Our two boys rush down the court. And they're attacked by a hammerhead shark on the way. They have to collect stars and decorate Penny's posterior. That gentleman's a butcher called Philip, and the other guy's a big lad, 6'2". Two stars for Penny. We need four. Four stars, two for each boy. Or however, yes?
Thirty-nine seconds.
Again, is very good.
But
a couple of hefty boys. There's Philip coming through, a butcher and boxer from Sherborne in Dorset. Thirty-nine seconds to beat. There's a hammerhead shark. And he's from Yugoslavia. The two boys from Portugal. Eduardo and Umberto from the island of San Miguel. Out there in the Atlantic, off the coast of Portugal. Two stars on Teresa's posterior. Oh, good tackle, look at that. Yes, big Yugoslav. Coming up for 30 seconds. Three stars. And we're on our joker. And thank goodness for that big Yugo. Because they're on 40
40 seconds from outside our time.
Ecco, il pezzo è già pronto, possiamo dare il via anche a questa terza manche. La nostra, siamo la ragazza, che deve raggiungere la sua posizione.
Attenzione, 3, 2, 1. Off, rip the Belgian team from Toulouse. Ah, another good tackle there.
Non è che sono di scala, che
sono di scala, ma non Ah, oh, have a head shock. And he's waiting for his adversary. He took an early bump, then he might say. We've got to hold him up for a little longer than this. Three stars coming in. Inside the time. That's it, and we've just been beaten, I think, 34 seconds.
A questo punto si vede che ci un pensierino su come comportarsi, perché stanno tutti facendo dei tempi eccezionali.
Peggio a 34 secondi.
Addirittura 34 secondi.
34.
Questa è una.
Era good tackle by the hammerhead, but not good enough to put it in first place.
Sono già pronti alla linea di partenza.
Vai, The shark this time is a Frenchman. Oh.
Non si lasciano certo intimidire concorrenti dalla presenza di questo dell'avversario in piscina.
There are two stars. It must be difficult sticking them on with Velcro tonight because there's so much rain about. It's still coming down. Oh!
Tre, questa.
Super tackling there.
But.
Again, I think we've lost points. We make it up here unofficially. 36 seconds. We're now in third place. And the scoring of the Joker, as you know, is 6 for the win. 4 for the second, 2 for the third.
Mauro. Allora, tira questo Mauro, mi raccomando. Concentrazione e decisione estrema.
Italians on the Joker.
Italiano Gennaro?
Chasing the time of 34. Set up by the Belgians.
Attenzione. 3, 2, 1.
Parte la manche dell'Italia. Tira
questo
Mauro.
Oh, good tackle there from the opposition.
Una stella,
gioca with the Belgian. And he's sunk. Oh, look at this for a run. Two in 15 seconds. If the fastest hand will come in and finish first. Two runs. He's got to get him there. Oh! Coming up four. 29, 30. And they put her in. They put her in.
Into
the point. Well, they won the first game, Lignano. And they could win this one too.
30
secondi per Lignano.
30.
E adesso c'è solamente l'ultima manche che può impensierire.
And our joke is gone.
Che possono ancora eventualmente battere la nostra prestazione. E adesso la squadra di Šibenik, Jugoslavia, che dovrebbe cercare di migliorare il nostro record di 30 secondi. Naturalmente senza togliere nulla ai nostri avversari, speriamo che questo non succeda.
Last of the Yugoslavs used to water, they come from the Dalmatian coast. Very happy scene, by the way, they've been singing and dancing. I don't think they've particularly come here to win, but rather to enjoy themselves. Very young.
quella che ha fatto l'Italia, due stelle.
Quite phlegmatic. They haven't been racing about the place, just been crossing the rail, drinking the wine, and they brought their own band as well, the dance band in here. We've had a lot of fun, only the weather's upset them. A little conversation piece there between a Swiss gentleman and a Yugoslav. And you might see the Swiss gentleman coming out. There he is, coming out of the shark.
47 seconds.
So we finished in fourth place, but our joker, no points. 6 points for the Italian, plus six for the joker. Five points for Taru. 4 points for Swiss. 3 points. Well, if you're confused, the scoreboard has forgotten to put the joker on it. Here it comes now. And I must confess, I never saw the Belgian joker being played. But they played it. So, the readout. Lignano with the lead with 18. Tarut with 10. Schaven with 6. Regendorf 4. Sherman 4. Beach 3. San Miguel 3. You love this game. It's all about champagne. Boy and girl on the run. We don't play, relax. 16 going 4, 5 bottles of champagne. The last one doesn't get a bottle, is automatically eliminated. But the last one back is also eliminated. So it's a straight race back. Yugoslavia, Portugal, Italy, Switzerland, France, Belgium. And who's in the lead? The Swiss is the lead. They're the Swiss. They should be good at this game. Plenty of practice on the lakes of Switzerland. The bottle of acid for Manzi goes in first for the Swiss. The Yugoslavs are there. The Italians are in. Who's off? Well, meanwhile, back at the island, one of those back on the island. Who's won? Who's not?
Di difficoltà per i nostri ragazzi, comunque ce l'hanno fatta, sono ancora in gara.
So the Belgians and the French have gone. 14 going for 3 bottles. The last two eliminated. Obviously the one without the champagne. And the last hope, the Swiss are in. Hot team. The Italians are up. They've got one. So the Portuguese have gone.
Difficoltà, ha portato la bottiglia, adesso si tratta.
The Portuguese have gone, but it's a straight race back. Who's in first? It's the Swiss. The Swiss and the Yugoslavs are going hammer and tongs to the Italians. It's going to be the Italians out. Big disappointment all round because the Portuguese are just flashing around. And it could be, certainly Portugal have gone, and we think the Italians. So at the moment, we're running away with the competition here tonight. They needed to be picked back, and yeah, Swissness has done it. The grand final, the Swiss and the Yugoslavs. And this time, they have to open that great big magnum, or mega magnum, or is it a jelly bone, or is it a Methuselah? But the Swiss are first up, whoa, up it goes. Lovely performance there by the Swiss. It's nice to see the Yugoslavs coming. They're here for fun. They haven't come for Olympic Games. We come to enjoy themselves, and I think you'll enjoy the program too. By the way, the wind has dropped slightly. It was gusting for 9.
now down to about 4-6.
Francia un punto, vediamo adesso insieme la classifica, siamo in testa, abbiamo già giocato il jolly ma abbiamo un notevole vantaggio, forza Lignano, vediamo che cosa succede.
Well, we're not showing at the moment very much, I'm afraid, but it's a long way to go, so keep your fingers crossed and let's go for round two of this exciting route. Remember, we are chasing a time of 1:33. Our two boys this time, Peter Mason and Jeff Palmer, they're going for red cakes, folks. Three red cakes in your fastest possible time. Each team with two different boys going for red cakes. The important man is the slim one, not in the costume. And ours is Peter Mason. 1:33, we're going. Here come the Italians, followed by the Yugoslavs. We've got the clock on it. We've had 25 seconds and no cake. I haven't seen a Brit yet. Oh, yes, here he comes. The Fat Boy. Our British boys have the same occupation, by the way. Coming through now, the two runs. They are both jig boarders in the aeronautical industry. They both come through together. That's two in 50 seconds. Chasing 1:33. Oh. The Swiss are in. Oh, what a time. 1 minute. Good team, this Regensdorf team. All cowbells and cheese. Strong team. Well, there's an impasse there. We're trying to get through. The doors burst open. Yugoslavia finished. There's the Swiss, the Yugoslavs, the Italians. The next cake. Can we beat 1:33? We're up to 1:33 now. It could be we have not beaten 1:33, but certainly an incredible time there by Regensdorf for something like 1 minute. At the moment, we're lying fourth in the Civil Rouge with a time of 1:33.
Ottima performance della.
Oh, 49 seconds. They go top. So 1:21 for Yugoslavia. 1:24 for the Italians. We were four. We're now not. We're in fifth place. Portugal 1:30. Britain have a time of 1:31. So all the new times are there. The Swiss 49, the Yugoslavs 121, the Italians 124, the Portuguese 130, we're in fifth place with 131, the Belgians 135, the French 143. We need to improve on that. All the times are coming down apart from ours. You'll enjoy this game. It's called Rodeo. A big fish, a big red mullet from the Adriatic Sea is hauled up the pool by a girl. 8 seconds later, another whistle. And there is launched a raft. A boy at the back and a girl prone at the front. They're launched and on their way. They try to overhaul the fish. Soon as a raft touches the fish, they're after the balloon. Little Belgian girl is hauling on the rope in the rain, still coming down. In come the Portuguese, touch the fish. Hammer, bop, bop and bop. Time taken. Three balloons in quickest time. Could be 31 seconds. Still is here a bit of a mess.
Abbiamo per il Portogallo il primo tempo 31 secondi.
31 secondi per il Portogallo.
31 seconds for Portugal. One. Time to go for.
Invece la Gran Bretagna, Sherbourne, e dall'altra parte c'è una concorrente di Dushan Moser, lo precede.
Attenzione. The British go. 2, 1.
Ecco the French go. Called Natalie Hall for a life.
2, 1.
There's little Sue Rowe, the smallest competitor I've ever seen in knockout. She's only 4'10" and weighs in, would you believe, 6.5 stone. She's come up, she's got the hammer, bonk. Come on, little Sue, a great competitor, yes. You see the size of her. Two better than Compton. She's a super little girl. A shop assistant is Sherbin, having a real duffy.
La Gran Bretagna un tempo di 23 secondi.
23 seconds. Excellent time. We need the point. The French. From beach.
Attenzione. 3, 2, 1.
The Swiss fish.
Attenzione. 3.
Christine pulls on it, the rain
keeps it down.
A beautiful launch for the French. Well, she's putting out to the points. Whatever happens now, they can't beat the French. Oh, dear.
Se un pallone si stacca, ammettiamo che è valevole. Se un pallone si detache, il è naturalmente valabile. When un pallone è rausgeht, dann ist es gültig. That's good for that balloon.
The balloon's all right.
Allora il pallone era buono, l'ultimo abbiamo la Francia e Greco col Portogallo con 31 secondi.
31 seconds.
Per la Francia, adesso abbiamo una marina molto particolare.
I wish we played the Joker on this game, I can hear you all saying at home, but I think I might agree with you.
Attenzione, 3, 2, 1.
The Swiss themselves, and a Portuguese girl who is not exactly rippling with muscle.
3, 2, 1.
8 seconds to whistle.
E vediamo come si raccalda.
They're intent on doing a bit of a damage to that fish. 15 seconds, remember our time, 23. Coming for 20. She needs to make contact, has done. 22, 23. Disappeared. Boom. And the head's come off the hammer.
È andata. Anche per la squadra di Regelsdorf, mi sembra che la loro prestazione sia piuttosto buona. Sono stati abbastanza rapidi.
Buon tempo, ma non ancora il primo. La Svizzera 27 secondi.
Seconda migliore prestazione per Regelsdorf con 27 secondi, mentre la migliore rimane ancora quella di 23 secondi fatta da Sherbourne. Per ultima manche abbiamo il Belgio contro una concorrente jugoslava.
Attenzione, 3, 2, 1.
Dejana,
2-1
from Yugoslavia, pulls the rope.
Partiti in questo momento.
Kathleen and Johansson from Turut on the Belgian raft.
Direi piuttosto rapidi, il nuotatore è abbastanza deciso, sono caduto in acqua, ho operato troppo presto.
No, I think she might be disqualified. The rules are quite clear, unless you make contact with the fish with the boat.
Questo non è valevole perché la ragazza è saltata in acqua prima di aver raggiunto il pesce. Ça n'est pas valable parce que la jeune fille a sauté dans l'eau avant d'avoir rejoint.
That's right, the rule is quite clear.
The girl jumped into the water before reaching the fish.
Oh, they could
allora
regret that.
Abbiamo, come abbiamo detto,
the Belgians.
Non è valido perché
it could cost
in acqua
valuable point.
A zero.
The rules are quite clear. The boat must make contact with the fish before you can start the first jibber. It's a bit of a hard cheese for the Belgians, but let's see what the Yugos can do.
Attenzione, 3, 2, 1.
Sally Bonnell, teacher of small boys, sometime of Sherbourne.
Ed eccoli in acqua. I concorrenti di Sherbourne sono arrivati qui a Lignano con
Her lovely blonde tresses drenched. I feel it spoiled, but it's not a glamour game tonight. Think of that poor girl there. Oh, she's determined enough. Grim determination of Sister Sally's face. The Yugoslavs still have to burst the balloon to get a time. But no matter what happens, the British have won. We're in for 6 points.
Allora abbiamo il primo posto della Gran Bretagna con 6 punti.
6 punti a Sherborne.
Poi la Svizzera,
which is well up the board.
5 punti a Regensburg.
Il Portogallo, 4 punti.
4 punti a Saint-Miguel.
La Francia è secco col Portogallo, anche 4 punti.
4 anche a Saint-Miguel.
The Italians, of course, didn't play. Everybody, of course, misses the game. You all know the rules by now, which is a frontier.
Aggiungiamo allora a questo punto la classifica in testa.
But Lignano with the lead, 22. Regensburg 15, Toulouse drops a few, 13. Jabinic 12, Sherman 10, San Miguel 10, and Vichy for France, only 8. In comes the French joker.
Okay, bon chance, grazie. Allora, questo adesso è un gioco.
Well, a very risky game to play it on. The legend of this game is Dabbiadori, who has 5 miles to stand. Beautiful, clean, white sand, and they value it very highly. These guys are pinching the sand on their backs, 30 pounds in a sack. Two boys pinching sand, riding fixed-wheel bicycles, but the course is bumpy. The girls who normally sunbathe here, but are now sheltering from the rain, don't like the sand being dicked. They're going to throw that girl at the bicycle. Plus all sorts of other sorts. Down the course they go. First comes the water. 2 best scoring. The number of hills covered. Or the fastest run. He's taking his time. Estiviano was thrown. Contestant number 2 from Yugoslavia. I'd put money on that guy getting anywhere, especially where the angry girls helped him with the stuff. Any moment, I think. Finding his trousers too tight. Somebody will get him. That's Penny with the ball. There's a doll coming yet. Miss Lignano. But they've got a time for 2.
And the minute is 15. Allora 1:15 per Civedi, che d'altra parte la Yugoslavia non vanta con dei campioni.
1:15 for the Yugoslavia. As you were. There it goes. The Belgians, well, they invented the game, actually, didn't they, of racing on bikes, so they should be red hot. And he looks like a bicyclist with those muscles, but he ain't too keen. Now they're all paddling along, they're not really pedaling, they're just treading it. They're taking their time. The Yugoslavs showed them how to do it. We've never seen this in practice. And it's so
soft.
The Yugoslavs showed them the way to do it by putting it all the way. Now this may be better. This is a confident boy for you. Look at this. Oh! He was looking so confident. We'll see an action replay of that, I'm sure. How many hills did he cover? Here it is. Here. Wait for it. Well, here come the British now. Philip Coulson. Oh, no, nearly. Oh, and this is a Brickman. The time for two runs. We need to be going faster than this minute. He's covered 6-0. 7. Will this Lignano get him? Come on, Philip. You're slow. Fast. He's slow, but he's done it. Now then, who's next? David, fast. Big David. He gets the water. The Yugoslav throws the ball. The French girl, similarly. The Swiss. If he survives that loss, he comes through to this Lignano. Who's got him? But he's covered. How many hills? 9. Big Dave fell by a dummy. The Yugoslavs still in the lead. We're second at the moment.
La distanza per la Gran Bretagna me l'hanno corretta è 19 e non 20.
Ecco,
pour le marquoir la distance pour la Gran Bretagna.
So the distance covered is 19.
Allora la distanza è
19 for Britain, 15 for Belgium, but in the right hand side the time of 1:15. Oh, look at the Italians go. Survives the water. Oh, that was lucky. Ah, this Lignano again. Felled by his own beauty queen. But he's covered 10 hills, 9 hills. Well, they're not hanging around, are they? Look at this, the look of sheer despair. He survived all the horrors of war and conflict. Tempest and hurricane. Yeah. Set his face, but he knows he's going in. Look at him. Oh, yes. Well, they say the game there is the right spirit. Regenstorf. Oh! There's Teddy Fowler with the ball. The Belgian girl, cat and mouse, fistive, the Swiss left. Hits the bike, but he survives. Now, what about the deadly Miss Lignano? Contestant number 2. Magnificent. I hope you're all enjoying the video disc, the action replays. Poetry in motion, still for all time. The French on their joker.
molto deciso.
Well, it's a risky one to play, so they must be pretty ace, these boys. Oh! Well, he's been struck three times. Will Miss Lignano, will she get him? Oh! Yep! Oh! Well, a great piece of balancing. He deserves his point. That was fast. Contestant number two. We need him to go to the drink. Otherwise, we're finished second, so he's fast. Oh, beautiful riding. No doubt about it, yes. He's the up! He's knocked a chunk out of the set. That big handsome Frenchman from Bitch. Well, you've seen everything, every aspect of the game that we've possibly had. You saw it all there. The humour and the skill, the tumbles. Voilà. The French beat us by one. 20 heroes. 6 points for Chabernick.
5 punti Pitch.
Pitch 5. Plus 4 for the Joker. 4 points for Sherbourne. 3 for Turut. 3 for Savioloro. Just 1 point for the Swiss, so anything could happen still tonight. Nobody opening up a lead. Lignano 25, Chevenek 18, Bitch 17, Turut 16, Regensdorf 16, Sherbourne 14, and San Diego only 10. Round 3. Phil Rouge. 100 cakes backstage of different colours. What colour will it be this time? The boys have to go for. Yellow is the colour. They go for the yellow cake. So let's just have a recap. You know the game by now, they're going for yellow cake. The fat boy and the thin. Once again, two different boys from each of the 17. Our boys are David Mason and Ian Rowe. Here we come. We have won. The Italians have two. Guerrero is trapped. You can see the determination, but they can't do a thing about it. I'll run down the times for you. The fastest so far, after two heats. The Swiss with 49, the Yugoslavs 121, the Italians 124, the Portuguese 130. The British in fifth place with 131 at a very fast time. They have the Belgians, who are at the moment lying in sixth place with 135, so they go up the leaderboard. You have to beat your best time, otherwise the old time stands. Coming through, our Larry Ian Rowe. But I think that's only two, yes. Chasing a time of 131, we're on 130, and we will not get a new one. Oh, the Italian, always giving you fun. They put a lot into it, look at that. Oh, he's so angry with himself. We have three, but we're outside our best time. We can forget it. You chuck away the worst time in each of the four heats, you keep the best. Coming up to limit time, impasse. Oh, a lightning time. 57 for the Belgians. Up the ball to go. The Swiss stay in the lead. 131 21 for the Italians, so their previous time stands at 1:24. 1:44, we chuck that away, and still retain 1:31.
La Francia 1:46
per la Francia. 1:46, they scrap that time and keep 1:43. There's the read out, the Swiss in the lead with 49, the Belgians 57, the Yugoslavs 1:21, the Italians 1:24, the Portuguese 1:30, we slip down now to sixth place, and the French are last. So there's one more round to come, and we need to improve on that one. To our next game, entitled The Dream, a couple planning a naughty weekend on a desert island to compete with four bags, and in comes the Portuguese joker, the Swiss, and the Belgian. Only one joker still to come, and that is the Yugoslav. To carry on with the story, the happy couple escaping for the weekend with four bags. Whatever happens in the next 1 minute 30 seconds, they've got to hang on to those bags. Into the pool. Into the pool, up to the island. Up to the island we go. Clamber aboard. The French, the Italians, the Swiss. And when you've reached second base, complete with bags, complete with couple, end of game. The Italians, it's greased the trees. The Italians have done it. That's the game. The gentleman is still slim, but unfortunately, his partner has been at the spaghetti at the Tagliatella and put on a few pounds. The French are up. The game is when you get your feet on that second base. Seconds for Beach. 43 for Regensdorf. Oh, 38 seconds to the Italians. Second heat becomes very important now because with two jokers being played, the Portuguese and the Belgian. Little Stu Rowe is going for us. 4'10", eyes are blue. Eloping with Mr. Palmer. Mr. Palmer's quite tall, and I would think he will chuck little Stu right up onto first base. He's a bit short of stature, but light in weight. Mr. Palmer will hand her a few bags, clamber aboard, and go for a time. We hope beating the Italians of 38 seconds. Game's over when you're off to second base. Belgians are up. Belgians are there. We're there too. The Portuguese are struggling, and the time could be 40, just outside the Italians. They're a marvelous little competitor. Miss Rowe, 4'10", 6.5 stone, wet through as she is tonight, like everybody. There's Miss Rowe in the background. Master Palmer helping aboard. 43 for Portugal. 48 for Belgium is 48. And 40. 40 for Sherbin. So we're just shaded out.
Per l'Italia, 6 punti.
6 punti a Lignano che vince questo stesso gioco.
6 points for Lignano, but we pick up 5. Well done, this row. She's bagged us 11 points on her own tonight, actually. But somebody needs to peg back the Italians. Everybody else, even their match, but the Italians at the moment running away with the competition.
Allora, 6 punti anche per Regensdorf.
Dopo, per il Belgio, due punti e niente per il Jeux.
Due punti e hanno sprecato
the Belgian out of it. Another joker gone west. But the readout, Lignano 31, Regensdorf 22, Sherbet 19, Turut 18, Beach 18, Shevenig 18, San Miguel 16, but we're up in third place and still racing. Preserve Joker. They all look like that from Dalmatians. They're all bearded with big sad eyes, but they're very cheerful people. The last joke of the night. There's our Prince Charles going to the rescue of the fair Lady Diana. The Italian sense of humor. But unfortunately, we're being blasted to bits by adversaries with great catapults. You've got to come back with as much of your ship intact as you possibly can. But you see the British, not the British rather, as you were, a Royal Navy boat, Prince Charles, the Italians and the British. Ciao Mama is the Italian. So we turned round, the British boat. Prince Charles, you see a young girl going in there. That's Sally Bedell. She has to come back. They protect their boat. Six sheets of polystyrene make the boat and the funnel. Seven elements. And our captain is Chris. You can just about see him. You can see the method of propulsion. The time is taken, and you get bonuses for every piece of boat intact. The funnel counts five. Intact side counts five. And the bombs are flying in all directions. But now let's have a look. Our Prince Charles boat looks a bit chatty.
Lignano 72 secondi, la Gran Bretagna un tempo leggermente superiore 84, però due paratie buone, un cagnolo 15 meno, fa un tempo netto per la Gran Bretagna di 69 secondi.
Oh, it's a good time, a better time than the Italians, 69 seconds. We had more sheets of our ship intact than the Italians, 72 for Lignano. The Swiss of the Yugoslav. The captain, of course, is... Oh, he did it. He took it. The bombardiers. The captain of the Swiss Navy, and they do have a navy, by the way. The Yugoslavs. The Swiss on the right, the Yugoslavs on the left, and everything intact. We can do with better aim from the right. Our Britons just about to let one go. Yes. The young girl dives in, comes in the back of the boat to another hole, and she can sit or stand or do what she wants. The Yugoslav's taking a bit of a bashing. Ah, you have to wreck him there. A bomb on the Swiss boat. They laughed at the name of the Swiss boat. And the Yugoslavs on the Joker. What a dangerous game to play the Joker on. The quickest time wins.
Dunque ricordo il tempo dell'Italia era di 72 secondi, vediamo adesso le altre squadre che hanno fatto meglio. La Yugoslavia 82 secondi che si sono la paratia e il movimento tempo effettivo per la Yugoslavia 72 lo stesso
72. So we're still in the lead.
76.04 oggetti stati 20 secondi.
Questo è beat it. Tempo The French and the Portuguese.
La belle poule per la Francia e invincibile, invincibile per il Portogallo.
No, he's it. Well, he took it too. He's going over. No, he is. Yes, he lost the bubble. Little Jacob bashing now. The bubble's all over the place. That's 5 seconds. Stop, he says. Let me get a board, you idiot. Oh, he gets the board, he rips another piece off it. Well, you can see the method proposal, you can see the game now. You know exactly how it works. Anna, get the board. As best you can. Now she's left behind. In all sorts of trouble now, on a collision course. They really are taking a pacing. The French girl hanging on to the funnel, there's very little of the ship left. The French Navy of Toulon taking a real hammering. I think we might have come second in this game. The captain disappears from the bridge. The stoker down below is still paddling. Collision course with the French. Chaos.
Abbiamo la Francia, 87 secondi meno 2 elementi.
Seventy-seven for the French.
77
for the Portuguese. We finished with 5 excellent points. Not remarkable recovery by Sherbert. Coming up well on the road.
5 punti per Sherbourne. Dopo abbiamo la Jugoslavia con 4 punti più 2 punti per il Jolly. Allora 4 più 2, 6 punti per Sivenik. Però l'Italia è secco con la Jugoslavia, 4 punti.
4 punti per Lignano.
La Francia, 2 punti.
2 punti per Vichy Moselle.
E secco con il Portogallo, 2 punti.
E 2 punti per il Portogallo. Io spero che Milli sia in ascolto e sia vicino a un monitor.
Lignano 35, Regensdorf 28, Sherbert 24, Scheveningen 24, Beach 20, Torut 18, Sandigol 18. We pulled ourselves off the bottom, but now can we beat our time of 1 minute 31 seconds? We're going for green cake.
Allora, verde il colore delle torte che bisogna andare a prendere nel magazzino. Diamo il via a questa ultima manche.
Attenzione, 3, 2, 1.
Ed ecco partita la manche, risolutiva dei Jeux. Entrano come furie nel deposito dei dolci. I concorrenti delle 7 squadre.
It's important to come through quickly, first time. There's young Phillips, yes. No, it's David Butts. Hold yourself out of the drink. If we can just get through, there the German team, hoping for the best, but an impasse is setting in behind the stage. It's absolutely vital to get your little man through. And there is no way they're going to get through there at all, because this is bad news for Sherbert. The longer the jam is there, the worse it looks. At the back end of that queue, trying to get through is Philip of Sherbert. We've won, and the time is going now very rapidly. Ebbing away, 1 minute 5 seconds. We needed a minute, and I don't think we're going to do it. 1:15. That great log jam of competitors is really, really now bringing the times down.
And of course, if I were a Swiss gentleman, I wouldn't be too keen on getting anywhere with a time of 49 seconds. Don't forget that they can play a few tactics with two, but we've blown it. The Portuguese celebrate. I don't know why, because I don't think they've beaten their time at 1:30. Coming for 2 minutes limit. Well, Philip has just progressed on that queue at all. Impossible. One or two of those guys didn't really want to go anywhere, especially the Yugoslavs and the Swiss and possibly the Italians. Well, Portugal beat their time. A knock 6 seconds off. The Swiss won't bother at all about that. Neither will the Belgians. Nor the Yugoslavs. Only the Portuguese time. Only. The rest of us were out of time. So some holding tactics backstage. Maybe the jam in the swing doors wasn't by accident. Well, unfortunately, we were coming, but we just needed a better fil rouge time than the one we had. If we could have picked up 7 points, we may not have dented the Swiss and the Italians, but we could have come somewhere. At the moment, we've slipped one place. The Yugoslavs come up. We come to the last game. And it's the Italians against the Swiss. The Italians, 39 points. The Swiss, 35. The Yugoslavs, 29. Sherman, 26. Sarut, 24. San Miguel, 22. And Beach, 21. The rain still melting down. All teams play the last game. A little wind surfing. A boy and girl. Begin. The boy inside. He goes in, he gets under. He propels the beast up the pool. The girl astride. A straight race, straight up the pool, and back again. Where are we? Well, we had a terrible launch. A bad launch. In the lead, the Italians. Then the Swiss. Italians nearest to us. Straight race between these two for the destination of the silver trophy, awarded, as you know, for winners of internationals. The beast turns round. The Italian pig. The Swiss dog. And then you board two other ladies. Two other girls clamber aboard. One has to stand up. The rule is that one has to stand, and it's a straight blast back down the course. We've caught a crowd, the Italians don't look too stable. The Swiss coming in, but they've... It's over, the Swiss winning, the Italians have got to finish well down. The Swiss have got to pull up 5 points. Now the rule was quite clear, that one girl has to stand. And the British are coming up, then you see them in the middle lane, the Brits. Jeff Barber propelling Sue, Betty and Sally aboard. Now the Italian girl has stood up. She sat down all the way, but then stood up. Well, they say they've won. We just have to wait and see. It was a clear rule. One girl has to stand, the other two sit. But it would be a very brave referee indeed who disqualified on the last game. I think those celebrations may be for real. The shouts go up, Lignano, Lignano. Shall we see them in the final later on? Or will the Italian team playing away beat the score? Yes, the Italians have won it. Confirmed. Second for Switzerland, break and score. Wonderful recovery there by our British team. They were trailing by miles on the first lap. Then suddenly picked up speed. The point. And leave it in Italian for you.
Per la Svizzera 6 punti, per la Gran Bretagna 5 punti, per il Portogallo 4 punti, per il Belgio 3 punti, per la Jugoslavia 2 punti e finalmente per la Francia 1 punto.
Michele, attenta per l'ora finale.
So the final score, leading from the bottom, the French were 7-22, 6 were San Miguel with 26, 5th were Zeldin with 27, then equal 3rd were Chamberlain with Claudia and Sherman for the Brits with 31 points apiece, in 2nd place the Regan score with 41, and the winners were Lignano and Teodoro with 46 points, enormous total. On a night that really wasn't made for Italian hijinks, you know, the Italians always play well when the sun shines. They're never too cheerful when it rains, but look at that rain, it's been incessant all day. It's just belting down, coming straight off the Adriatic Sea. The fireworks go up. From Poppy's step. And so, I think, from this lovely scene in the Lignano Sabbiadoro, good night to you all.